Hello guys, welcome back to the new video. The umbilical tower now moving away from the soil. The flight engine for the first stage will come up to flight speed momentarily. The second umbilical tower will be dropping back from the soil in just a matter of seconds. There it goes. We are standing by for main engine start and liftoff. Liftoff of the Soyuz rocket. Shannon Walker, Fyodor Yurchikhin and Doug Vlog begin their journey on the 100th launch on behalf of the International Space Station. Arcing out over the Kazakhstan skies, the Soyuz vehicle good pitch program according to the flight controllers, good first stage performance, the Soyuz delivering 102 tons of thrust from its four boosters and single engine. 1 minute into the flight, the Soyuz now traveling 1,100 miles per hour. Pressure 798, can you access G load? About 2 to 2.5 units. Fyodor Yurchikhin reporting about 2 GS as the vehicle approaches the period of maximum dynamic pressure. Now they have stronger vibration at the assault. We are standing by for the shutdown and jettison of the four strap on boosters. And now we have first stage separation. The boosters dropping away at an altitude of 30 statute miles. The Soyuz traveling 3,950 miles an hour, 73 miles downrange from the Baikonur Cosmodrome. Normal parameters being reported for all of the Soyuz systems. A good view inside the descent module. Shannon Walker, the board engineer, heading towards space. Fyodor Yurchikhin, the Soyuz commander, at the bottom of your screen. 2.5 minutes into the flight, standing by for escape tower and launch shroud jettison. The Soyuz now 52 miles in altitude, 102 miles downrange, traveling 4,500 miles an hour. And the view of Doug Vlog, flight engineer number 2, seated to the right of Fyodor Yurchikhin. The Soyuz sailing on toward orbit. All systems reported in excellent shape. The Soyuz core stage or second stage performing as advertised. This stage is 56 feet in length, 13.5 feet in diameter, providing 96 tons of thrust, 230. Now just beyond the 4 minute mark into the flight, all of the Soyuz systems performing normally. Board pressure is 798. 270 seconds control system parameters are nominal. Okay, thank you. And we can see it on the display inaudible, just a few seconds away from the second stage separation. And now the visiting vehicle officer confirmed second stage separation. The core booster has burned out and separated in an altitude of 104 miles. The Soyuz 179 miles downrange from the Baikonur Cosmodrome, traveling 8,700 miles an hour. The Soyuz now being propelled by the single engine of the Soyuz third stage. This engine providing 30 tons of thrust. It will burn for just over 4 minutes in the cloudless skies over the Central Asian desert. The Soyuz vehicle streaking toward orbit still visible. 360 seconds pitch you roll in nominal. And this view inside the International Space Station, Tracy Caldwell Dyson on the right, Mikhail Korninko and Alexander Skvortsov watching the launch of the Soyuz vehicle and the transport of their three colleagues toward orbit to begin the two-day orbital chase for docking. Thursday afternoon, 6.5 minutes into the flight, the Soyuz now traveling at about 12,000 miles an hour. Not quite 2 minutes left in powered flight for the TMA-19. Once the third stage delivers the Soyuz to orbit and the module is separated, a series of pre-programmed commands will be executed to prepare the Soyuz for orbital operations. Those commands, called time tech commands, allow many of the Soyuz systems to be automatically activated by the onboard computers at precise times. Now 7.5 minutes into the flight, everything proceeding normally. 450 seconds nominal flight, copy 450 seconds nominal flight. Stage 3 engines are nominal. Thank you very much. Everything is fine on board. We feel very good. Copy, Fyodor Yurchikhin reporting back to the flight controllers that everything is proceeding by the book. Less than a minute of a powered flight remaining. 490 seconds, the article is stable. 500 seconds, nominal flight. 510 seconds, pitch URL, nominal, copy, standing by for the third stage cutoff and suppression. Okay guys, all the best to you guys, that's it. Thank you so much, Anatoly. And now we have confirmation of third stage cutoff and spacecraft suppression. Hey, I knew you are a finicky guy. I knew you will do that and tell me that. Okay, but thank you anyway. Thank you very much. And you guys did great. Thank you. Olympus Mission Control, Moscow. How copy? This is 16-3. Big smiles on the faces of the crew in the Soyuz TMA-19. The Soyuz in its preliminary orbit at an altitude of 148 by 121 statute miles. Thank you, Fyodor. Thank you. All secondary, and we now have confirmation of the deployment of the solar arrays and the navigational antennas as controlled as the spacecraft now overseen from the Russian Mission Control Center in Korolev outside Moscow. A perfect ascent to the orbit for the next newest trio of residents headed for the International Space Station and on the repressurization activation. An international crew of four reached orbit following a successful launch to the International Space Station at 10:53 p.m. EST Sunday from Launch Complex 39A at NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida. NASA's SpaceX Crew 8 mission is the agency's 8th commercial crew rotation mission with the company to the space station. A SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket propelled the Dragon spacecraft into orbit carrying NASA astronauts Matthew Dominick, Mitchell Barratt, and Janet Apps, along with the Roscosmos cosmonaut Alexander of Gerbenkiv for a science expedition aboard the orbital laboratory. Congratulations to NASA and SpaceX on another successful launch to the International Space Station. On this Earth crew rotation mission, we are once again showing the strength of our commercial partnerships and American ingenuity that will propel us further in the cosmos, said NASA Administrator Bill Nelson. Aboard the station, the crew will conduct more than 200 science experiments and technology demonstrations to help fuel this new era of space exploration and benefit humanity here on Earth. During Dragon's flight, SpaceX will monitor a series of automatic spacecraft maneuvers from its Mission Control Center in Hawthorne, California. NASA teams will monitor space station operations throughout the flight from the Mission Control Center at the agency's Johnson Space Center in Houston. NASA coverage continues with audio-only commentary until the start of the rendezvous and docking broadcast. The Dragon spacecraft named Endeavour will dock autonomously to the forward part of the station's Harmony module about 3 a.m. Tuesday, March 5. NASA will provide live coverage of rendezvous docking and hatch opening beginning at 1 a.m. on NASA Plus, NASA Television, the NASA app, YouTube, and the agency's website. NASA also will continue coverage of the crew welcome ceremony once they are aboard the orbital outpost. Learn how to stream NASA TV through a variety of platforms, including a social media. Crew 8 will join the space station expedition 70 crew of NASA astronauts Jasmine Mogbelli and Laurel O'Hara, ESA, European Space Agency astronaut Andreas Mogensen, JAXA, Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency astronaut Satoshi Furukawa, and Roscosmos cosmonauts Konstantin Borisov, Oleg Kononenko, and Nikolai Chub. For a short time, the number of crew aboard the space station will increase to 11 until crew 7 members Mogbelli, Mogensen, Furukawa, and Borisov return to Earth a few days later. Crew 8 will conduct new scientific research to prepare for human exploration beyond low Earth orbit and benefit humanity on Earth. Experiments include a study of brain organoids to understand neurodegenerative disorders, shifts in bloody fluids during spacecraft and the effects of UV radiation and microgravity on plant growth. These are just a few of more than 200 science experiments and technology demonstrations that will take place during their mission. With this mission, NASA will maximize use of the space station, where astronauts have lived and worked continuously for more than 23 years testing technologies, performing science, and developing the skills needed to operate future commercial destinations in low Earth orbit and explore farther from Earth. Research conducted on the space station provides benefits for people on Earth and paves the way for the future long-duration trips to the Moon and beyond through NASA's Artemis missions.